the key origin story for Bitcoin. I have all these speculative thoughts on who Satoshi is. I went to this financial cryptography conference in early 2000. Satoshi was at that conference. The true Bitcoin origin story was one of the books that tremendously influenced me when I started PayPal was The Sovereign Individual. It was written by Rees-Mogg, and it was about how we were going to have cryptocurrencies, and it was going to be a decentralized world where sovereignty would get decentralized to the individual level. And I read that book in the summer of 98. I do think of Bitcoin as the real thing. It's sort of the centralized currency that we fantasized about at PayPal but didn't quite build. I have all these speculative thoughts on who Satoshi is. Let me give what I think is the key origin story for Bitcoin. When I started PayPal, I went to this financial cryptography conference in Anguilla in early 2000, sort of an annual conference, and they have sort of this gathering of people who are libertarian and into cryptocurrencies, and probably a decent number of people working at the NSA and spying for the US government and other governments as well. So it's sort of this rather interesting gathering of people. And my theory is that Satoshi was at that conference or at one like that in early 2000. And one of the manifestations of cryptocurrency at that particular conference was a system called eGold. And it was anonymous encrypted electronic gold certificates. And it was a company, it was based in Southern Florida. They had these servers distributed all over the planet. But it was, in theory, this gold-based alternative to the dollar. It was going to be encrypted and safe. And there were all these problems with eGold. We made it interoperable with PayPal. Turned out there was sort of a lot of criminal fraud, criminal activity. Maybe that's always part of the territory of these things. We sort of disconnected it. There was something about the eGold architecture that was in theory a cryptocurrency and in theory decentralized with their servers in Iceland and Dubai and, you know, one or two other places. But in practice, it was still centrally attackable by the larger central government. And I believe the true Bitcoin origin story was in contrast to eGold. You know, it's almost the same name in a way. It's like eGold, Bitcoin, you know, it has roughly the same, it's like you were thinking about eGold, okay, I'm going to do the next eGold, I'm going to change E to bit and coin to gold. It was sort of a contrast to that. And so I think the reason we do not know who Satoshi is integral to the history of Bitcoin. If we knew who it was, you know, our too powerful central government would probably do some very unpleasant things to that person.
We hope you found this video valuable. Let us know what your opinion on all this is down in the comments section. And don't forget to like it, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel for more content just like this.